You guys, I am speechless. And I tried to do a live stream just a few minutes ago. It wouldn't let me. So I'm going to do something better. I do not have permission to do this at all. Whatsoever. I decided to do this out of my own mind because I can't do a live stream for you guys. The words that this man said to me on the vitriol grad, it was probably the nicest thing I've heard in 2020, other than, you know, what my parents say to me, like, oh yeah, we love you and all that, when I heard my name pop up, I almost had a heart attack. My heart started racing, started getting really sweaty, and oh my god. As soon as I wake up in the morning, I'm sending my teachers a freaking text message saying thank you so very much. I don't even care. Here we go. This is the vitriol grad that I was a part of. And I'm just going to pause it so I can get to the part.
Family, to anyone graduating grade 8 from highview, you showed friendship to all, especially peers, but also younger students, staff, and administration. Tyler has come to highview for his entire life, and I am not sure if anyone in those 10 years has ever heard an unkind word from his lips. He is cheerful and kind to everyone. He is respectful to young and old. Tyler has excellent manners, and he is a dependable friend. He is a positive role model at outdoor playtimes, easygoing, and thoughtful. You feel like Tyler is supporting you all the way, no matter who you are.
Let me say something. Let me clarify something real quick. I'm gonna fix this light. Maybe if I put my head here. Let me clarify something here. Nobody on this planet has never, ever, okay, hold on a second. Oh my god. Has ever, okay, said that to me before. It's probably the nicest thing and the thing that I needed to hear in this challenging year. I want to thank everyone for saying that, you know, and so basically at my school, there's this giant silver trophy, and they're going to engrave my name into it, and they're going to take a photo of me holding it, and then they're going to keep that trophy in highview forever. It's going to be there forever. I'm going to be a part of highview for life. And like flipping, then they're going to give me a medal to keep. Okay, they're going to give me a medal to keep with my name engraved on it. And it's going to say the word friendship on it. Because I won the award of friendship. The trophy of I can't speak. Of friendship. I'm getting it on Thursday. And I can barely speak right now without bursting out in tears. Because I can't believe it, guys. I did not think I was going to win an award because I didn't. every freaking month this year has been so crappy, and I just thought that this was going to be one of them that I was just going to be, you know, off to the side, you know, every fun fair, you know, there's always those, like, bottles of candy, and you put your name in, you try to win. I never really won any of those except for one, and, you know, and I never really won anything like this, and it's really heartwarming that I am still alive to witness this and survive it and be able to tell the tale in the future and go to Fellows High School and to flipping, you know, see my friends soon, hopefully, and, you know, and just be able to vlog the experience, and it's unbelievable, and I am just so happy that I am still here, that, you know, I'm still alive, and, you know, so much bad stuff has happened in 2020, but finally something good has happened. So, I just got done watching the virtual grad video, so I just wanted to, hold on, someone's coming up. I wanted to say thank you so much. Of course, the teachers will most likely never see this, but I am going to send them an email when I wake up tomorrow, probably 12. No, I'm waking up at 7 today. Because I have a video to film for you guys. I'm getting the medal on Thursday. I will show you guys the photo, most likely. It's quite a big silver trophy, and I just can't believe it. You know, I've never owned an award like this before. You know, yeah, I've won stuff before, but nothing this major before, you know. And Isaac won an award, and Jack won an award, and Carter won an award. And I'm like, oh my God, the Friendship Miners won an award. I just hope that Austin is going to get an award when he graduates in grade 8. We need the entire Friendship Miners to get an award. Jacob got an award too. The entire Friendship Miners got a freaking award except for Austin, but his year is still yet to come, okay? Isaac got an award. I got an award for Friendship. Isaac got an award for a Highview Hawk, and I got an award for the Best Friend of the Year, and Jack got an award. I have to go back. I was in shock when I heard that I got an award. Jack got an award. Carter got an award. Jacob got an award. That's 5 Friendship Miners, guys. And when I saw that the flipping virtual grad was 1 hour and 9 minutes, I knew something was gonna... Something wasn't right. Something wasn't right. And I didn't think I was gonna win an award, but this world still has yet to surprise me. And, you know, my teachers were right, you know. Even though we didn't get to go on our grad trip because of COVID-19, Mr. G said, you still have a lot more to look forward to in life, and this is one of them, guys. You know, the awards, the flipping, and I know what you guys are thinking. Well, dude, abandon the medal, dude. Get rid of it. Because you obviously don't like medals. You know, not medals. You obviously don't like rewards. That's not true. I don't want the diamond play buttons because sometimes... Okay, let's put it this way. When I'm at school, I'll accept awards because that's different. If I'm on a social media platform and I get some play buttons to say, hey, you're doing good, not for an important graduation of my life, but just like 3 play buttons, I don't want them. I want an award from my school because I'm not going back. That was it. The next time I go to get the sweaters that they're giving me and the flipping award, that's it. I'm never going back. Yeah, I might walk into their gates sometimes during the summer break when all this is over, but that's it, bro. That's it. I ain't going back inside that school. No one is except for the teachers and future students. And, like, you know? So... Yeah, I was hoping that I had gotten an award, but I did not think I would get one. And it's incredible. And I just finished the grad view, and I came upstairs once my company was gone. The cake was good. And, you know, I just can't believe it, you know. I never thought that this would happen. It is, currently 8:10. No, 8:10, jeez. I'm gonna go for a drive real quick. And, I'll let the graduation video upload through my Chromebook. I made a graduation video, and then I'll upload this one at whatever time, basically after the other video uploads. So, yeah, thank you guys so much. You know, it's incredible. I can't believe it. Friendship, the best friend of the year. Well, let me just clarify that. That right there is the award that they're engraving my name into and putting it in highview forever. Basically, it's for a friend that was always kind to everyone, staff, teachers, principals, EAs, whatever, you know, kindergartens, grade eights, you know, even when I was in lower grade. And that is true. That is 100% true. Ask anyone. When I was at that school, I was the best I could ever be. And same goes for when I'm at home, on YouTube. I don't care where I am. I am the best of me. And ain't no one gonna change that. Wow. I didn't even know a friendship award existed. They give you a little slip of the awards that you can win. And they didn't have the names beside them. I thought that was a little sketchy, but I didn't think that I would win one, you know. And I know what you guys are thinking. Bro, you should be able to bring that trophy home. No. You think I got room for that thing? Thing's like freaking this tall. I can't put that in my room. It deserves to be with Highview at all times. That way, I am still with Highview. Right? You think about that real quick, okay? Anyways, let me finish this. So the award goes out to someone who was always friendly. That's me. That's true too. Like, it's so true, it's unbelievable. And I can't believe I didn't see it coming. Like, wow. I stood up for my friends, I helped my friends, even when I got into fights, I helped them, you know, and I was never rude to them. Not a single bit. I mean, yeah, we had some moments where we would get a little bit angry at each other. Because, let's face it, no one's perfect. Okay, you're going to get into arguments with your friends. It's just life. But afterwards, you always make up. But they're talking about people who punch each other in the face. That's what they say. Not someone, somebody who is truly rude, at least at my school, is when someone's like fist fighting. And trust me, a lot of those happened in flipping 2019. 2020 didn't give me a chance to help those people. There were a lot of people that I planned on helping this year. Because they kept on getting into fights. And one of them was one of my best friends, Dowson. And, you know, and he's my best friend. And, yeah, sometimes he gets a little angry. But I was planning on really helping him this year. And, you know, and this COVID-19 took away all the chances that I could have had to help more people. But, as you know, now that I think about it, I'm kind of, I don't know if I should say this because I might get in trouble, but I'm a little bit happy that we didn't have the graduation ceremony, only because if they had called my name while I was in the audience, I would have had to gone up on that stage next to my teacher. He's like, what, 9 foot tall? Let's just say the tomato would take over. And the part where he says he has came to Highview his entire life is true. 3 years, I was not at Highview. I was at home. I started going to Highview when I was 4 years old. I started from SK all the way up to 8. That is like, well, there was SK, and then there was JK, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 10 years of Highview. And I got the Friendship Award. If you guys think for that, just a little bit, okay? 10 years in your heart, you've been a good person. You help people. You help them with their schoolwork. You be there when they need you. And you're one of the nicest people that they know. And you don't even see this coming. You just do it out of the goodness of your heart. They never ask for anything in return, which is true. I never asked anything in return. I never said, oh yeah, I'll be nice to you if you give me this. I never said that. Never in my life. Okay? If we're supposed to have a lightning storm or thunderstorms, okay? If I have ever said, hey, if you give me that, I'll be nice to you. If I've ever said that, may lightning strike me now. Or thunder. Let thunder and lightning strike me now. Thunder and lightning now strike me. Must be true. Never ask for anything in return. And you just think about that. You're the kindest person. Well, not one of the kindest person, but you're one of them. You're amongst them, you know? And you're always there for your friends. You've assembled the team from the beginning. You've helped the team. You're the leader. And then all of a sudden, they surprise you with the Friendship Medal. And this is exactly why we stopped doing Vote for Leader. Every year, the team would basically vote for a new leader, right? So back in about grade 2, we assembled the team. Grade 3, in grade 4, Aiden came along. And he decided that he wanted to be the leader. And I said, okay, Aiden, you can be the leader for a year. So we all took a vote. We all said, vote for me or Aiden. Don't worry about hurting anyone's feelings. Just vote for me or Aiden. So they took their votes, and I ended up coming up on top. And Aiden turns to me, and he says, it's probably for the best, right? And I turned back to him, and I said, nah, Aiden, votes don't change anything. You get to be the leader. And he said, all right, I'll only be the leader for a week. And I said, you only want to be a leader for 7 days. I said, you can be a leader for 12 months, a whole year. And he said, nah, you're a good leader. And I'm not messing around, okay? I remember this like the back of my head. I remember how I met everyone. Jack, it was SK. I was playing in the sand with my little truck, you know. And Jack comes over and sits right next to me and says, hey, what you play? And I said, I am playing trucks and dumpsters. And he said, can I play? And I said, sure. So I handed him a truck and we started piling the sand all over the place. And eventually we met Jordan, Jackson, Farron, Flippin, Dakota, a whole bunch of people. That was team 1.0. And then we met Jackson, Jordan, and then came flipping grade 1, you know. I met Malik for the first time. He's another friend of mine, but he's not around anymore. He's not dead, he just moved away. You know, I met Malik for the first time. Okay. Get this, right? So I was sitting at my desk. And the teacher comes up to me and says, we're moving this kid here, Malik, to the back of the class. Because apparently he wouldn't stop talking to the people beside him. So I said, oh, great. He's going to interfere with my work. Turns out, this teacher did not know what they were talking about. It was a supply, so, I mean, come on. Can we all agree that some supplies aren't that good? They don't know their rules. The kids act up. Anyways, let me finish my story, guys. Stop interrupting me. So anyways, Malik comes sits beside me, right? And I talked to him. I said, dude, please don't get in the way of my work. I got a really good grade going on. I don't want to mess it up. And he said, yeah, no, man, I won't mess it up. Say, by the way, do you like Pokemon, bro? I like Lego, you know? And he would not stop talking. It was hilarious. I never met a kid like that before in my life, right? And so then, at recess, he comes running up to me as me and Jack are playing mixed up game, right? And he comes running up to me and says, what you playing? And I said, we're playing mixed up game. He says, can I be Wolverine? I said, oh, you know Marvel. Yeah, you can be Wolverine, but I'm Hulk. You better watch out. And he's like, Hulk? Wolverine could destroy him. So I was like, alright. So we started, you know, play fighting and all that. And then the EA comes over. He's like, hey, you're gonna go play fighting. No. Whatever. So that's how I met Malik for the first time. Grade 2. Didn't meet anyone new. Grade 3. Didn't know anyone. Meet anyone new. Grade 4. Me and Jack are over by the bottom fence. And Jack runs off. I said, hey, where are you going? He says, I gotta go see someone. Okay, it's not what you think. Okay, he's not seeing them. He's gonna go see them, see how they're doing. Okay? So they're like, alright, I'll just wait here. I can practice my moves. So he comes running up to me and I said, who's this? And he says, this is Aiden. I said, no. I don't know this guy. Where did you... Who is this guy? He said, no, he's cool. He's one of my friends I met. I said, okay, Aiden. Aiden, right? And we started becoming more and more friends. At the time, he was in grade 3 and I was in grade 4. So I was one grade above him. So I was sort of like his mentor at the time. Right? So I said, all right, Aiden. Ever heard of the game Mixed Up Game? He said, no, because me and Jack made it up. So I said, it's a game where you can do anything. You can mash your heroes, you can mix your heroes, you can be anyone you want, you can do whatever you want, fight whoever you want, battle whoever you want. So he said, alright, I'll be Anakin Skywalker. I said, Jack's Superman. I'm the Hulk. And you want to be Anakin Skywalker? And then I look down at his shirt, and he's got this nice Star Wars shirt. And I said, oh, you're a fan of Star Wars? And he said, yeah. And I said, did you know that they're going to try and bring Darth Vader back to life? And he's like, why? Because at the time, the rumors were going on that Darth Vader's spirit was going to come back somehow in The Force Awakens. Anyway, so then... so on and so forth. Grade 5 came. Ooh, boy. Well, maybe I should speak of this first. In grade 4, right? Grade 4. I came back from the washroom. And I hear this behind me. Well, it sounded more like this. Right? And I look behind me. And there's Isaac, right? I didn't even know him at the time. So I pretend to go into my classroom and he just walks right past me. I didn't even know him at the time. That was back in grade 4. Anyway, grade 5. What was? I remember this day. I was sitting right at my desk, all comfy, right? And he comes up to me like the freaking speedster he is. Comes up to me, I'm like, jeez. And he's like, hey, do you like Lego? I said, yeah, I love Lego. By the way, Malik introduced me to Lego. So I was like, yeah, bro, I love Lego. Why? He drops his whole bag of Lego on my desk. And he says, would you trade this whole bag of Lego for that Joker right there? It took the whole lunch for me to decide that, but I finally said, yeah, I'd trade that. Because Lego's important to me. So on and so forth. We started trading, becoming more and more friends. Grade 6. And then, grade 7. Oh, did I mention back in grade 4 we also met Carter for the first time? That was grade 2. My mistake. I'm so sorry. Okay, let me rewind. Maybe I'll put this in first. Also, in grade 2, I had met Carter for the first time. So I was sitting at the back of the class. I like the back of the class, okay? I was sitting there, and Carter starts talking to me. And he's a smaller fellow, which is okay. I respect him. Kid's a genius. Do not underestimate the Carter. So, this kid starts talking. Not a kid, I'm sorry. He starts talking to me, right? And all I'm hearing is his voice. I can't see him. Right? Because I'm sitting at my desk. Well, not my desk, but I'm sitting at a table doing my work, right? It was the table at the back of the class that the teachers are meant to sit at, not me. So even I was like, I don't know, right about here instead of right here. Anyway, so I hear him. So I look under the table and I see these feet and these hands. And I was like, what the heck? And so I look over and Carter's standing there and he's like this. He's like, hi. And I said, hi. And he said, do you like to draw? And I said, I love to draw. Right? Oh boy, that became a quick friendship. He started showing me knowledge and everything, and I started looking at him from time to time, and he was always reading books, Star Wars books from the library. My God. It was fun. Anyways, grade 7 came. Me and Isaac got split. I thought it was going to be the worst year ever. Me and Isaac would always know where to go. We would race to the spot where we hang out. We would race to it and see who got there first. Whoever touched their foot on the spot would win. Yeah, we got split. And it was just me, Josh, Aiden, and a few other kids that I kind of knew. And they weren't really friends, because they didn't hang out with me every recess, or whatever. I mean, I guess I'm too cool for them. Anyway, so yeah, okay, so yeah, I didn't really meet any new people in that year. Grade 8 came. Isaac introduced me to Brandon for the first time. Cool kid. Oh, I forgot Cooper. Jeez, there's a lot of kids, guys. My ear has been really bugging me lately. Kind of hurts. Anyway, I met Cooper back in grade 2. Actually, Carter was the one who introduced me to Cooper, and he was fast. He challenged me to a race one time, and I lost. Back then, I wasn't a runner. I didn't want anything to do with sports. I just wanted to get my work done and eat my flipping noodles for lunch. And, oh my God, I got so mad when I lost that race. I was so ready. I trained the night, you know. And he beat me like he was the Flash and I was a turtle. Right? So I come up to Malik and he's an amazing athlete. I say, hey man, I need your help, bro. I need to learn how to run. He said, alright, yeah, I'll teach you, bro. First thing you gotta learn. You always Okay, here's the number one secret that you need to know. When you're running, it's not just the legs that you need to keep in shape. It's also the... So anyway, so then grade 8 came and I met a lot of new people. There was a lot of new students. And you know, there are some friends I left out in this video because there's so many friends. Be here all day. You know, been Dustin, and, you know, Dakota. A lot of other people. Not all of them are good, though. I will tell you how I met Jacob and, Dowson for the first time. I will tell you that. Okay. We'll start with Jacob, because I met him first. So, back in grade 4, I sat down to do my work, right? And, of course, my teacher allowed us to listen to music for a little while, right? So I was like, I'm not gonna watch no music. I'm gonna watch Corey Kenshin. Bro, when I was done watching that video and we all came back to the table, and me and Jacob were like working, because Mrs. C put us in pairs, because she knew that me and Jacob would become good friends soon. And I was just like watching it, and I was like, I tried trolling him. I was like, on spectro, boy. And he drops his pencil. He's like, did you get that from Corey X Kenshin? I was like, wait, you know Corey Kenshin? He's like, yeah, he's a great YouTuber. I'm like, yo, he's been gone for a while. I was like, right? I know, right? And so we quickly became friends. We got into basketball, you know. I beat him. I mean, every time, you know, he totally didn't beat me a lot, you know. I beat him at every round. Every round. Anyway, so, yeah, so then, later on, I came back upstairs, and Jacob comes up to me during lunch, right? And he's like, yo, you gotta help me. And I said, what? He said, I got myself into a situation, and as you know, I'm always there for my friends no matter what, so I'm like, alright, what's the problem? And he said, I got myself into trouble. I said, alright, what's the trouble? He said, I'm getting to it. He said, there's this kid named Dowson, and I said I would hang out with him at recess, but I forgot that we had made plans. And so he said, I'm just going to run out the recess door and, you know, run away from him. So I said, alright, I don't know who this guy is. There was one new kid. Didn't know his name yet. It turns out to be Dowson. So anyways, we're running out, and I stop, and I look back at Dowson, and he said, hey, you told me that you would become my first friend. I don't got no friends. Show me what I know. And I felt so heartbroken. I know what it was like when I first went to Highview for the first time. And I had no friends. Nobody. And I was just sitting by myself playing with my trucks. And here comes Jack. Short and all. His nice little haircut, big black eyes, sits down. You wanna play trucks? Anyways. So I run, and I won, as usual. I won every recess. I'm not kidding, guys. I won every recess. Except for when I sprained my foot a few times. That happened a lot. But anyways, so... I asked Jacob, I said, yo, who was that guy? And he said his name was Dowson. I said, oh, well, he seemed kind of sad. He doesn't have any friends. Don't you know what it was like to, you know, be like that? Don't you want to go hang out with him? He said, no. Nah, man, I don't want to hang out with him. And I said, oh, So I was looking around for him, and I saw him walking alone, sort of sad. He had his head down, hands in his pocket, kicking rocks around, you know. So I walk up to him, and I said, "Hey, is your name Dowson?" He said, "Yes, my name's Dowson." And I say, "I understand that this kid named Jacob said that he would hang out with you recently." And he said, "Yeah, do you know where he went?" And I said, "Yeah, I know where he went, but I'm not going to tell you. I'm going to do you one better. I'm going to hang out with you." He said, "Oh, really?" I said, "Yeah, you look pretty sad, and I remember what it was like to go to Highview for the first time and not have any friends." So, he said, "All right." And Dowson, he was an odd one. He would make up with people, and then 2 days later, we'd be right back to step one. It was hilarious, but also worrying, because he would pick a fight with everyone, except for me. I would get in his way, and he would stop immediately. I told you guys, I was the leader of the pack, bro. Like, you don't hurt Oliver Queen. Right? Maybe I shouldn't compare myself to that guy. Because he's dead. You don't hurt Barry Allen. Have you seen Joe West punch Barry Allen in the face? I mean, yeah. Cisco's vibe blast him. Caitlin's frozen him with ice. But, I mean, they were under control of God, and Caitlin was kind of evil at the time, so. Anyway. The point is, you don't hit the leader. Because then, you're in big trouble. Big trouble, okay? You're screwed. The leader gets really angry. I don't get angry. Because if someone hit me, I don't really hit them back unless I feel it's absolutely necessary. Or if I don't know them. If they're one of my friends and yeah, they punch me, which I've never been really punched before. But if they punch me and they're my friend, I hold my jaw like this. And I go like that. And I say, "Feel better?" And he says, probably would say no. So then I probably get the teacher. And I know what you guys are thinking. That's the loser's way out. You're boring. Do you want to get smacked across the jaw 1,000 times on the ground? I'm not saying that Dowson was that violent. I'm just saying that sometimes he loses temper and push people around and stuff. But he's a good man, okay? So if you ever meet him, talk to him politely and say, "Hey, how's it going? How's your day going? You look good today, you know? Try doing that sometime." And if they slap you with your purse, tell him I said hi. Right? Anyways, guys, that is just me ranting. I still can't believe that I was chosen to be the best friend of this year. It's crazy, you know? I was always respectable, you know.
And I am not sure if anyone in those 10 years has ever heard an unkind word from his lips.
I'm not sure if anyone in those 10 years has heard an unkind word come from those lips. I will not lie. I have said a few wrong things to my friends before, like, "Oh, you jerk," or something like that. Well, I not necessarily call them a jerk, but I've been rude to them a few times. Like, I remember this one time when Aiden was kind of getting on my nerves. He ranted on and on and on. And I didn't know why. I figured out later on, next year, why he was acting so weird. But, I'm not going to say why, because this is extremely personal, and I'm a man of my word. When I make a promise, I make a promise. So, he kept going on and on and on, and he was ticking me off, right? And it was winter, right? So, I sort of gave him a little shove. You know, I haven't said verbally anything, but I sort of pushed him a little. And he flipped his lid. He pushed me to the ground and started flipping, moving my shoulders and stuff. And I was like, what are you doing? A dance? No. But, yeah, anyways. Aiden's also a good man. You know, and we all have those moments. I'm looking at you, dingus. I'm looking at you, okay, from this screen. You've had your moments too. We get pissed off at your parents because you can't have your device back. You can't go on this or on that. Give me my phone back. See? Anyway. But yeah, we all have our moments. Even I've had my moments before. And we all get over them when we became teenagers. We're like, man, that was me. So embarrassed. You know? But yeah, that's all I wanted to say is that I don't think this is 100% true. I mean, an unkind word? No, I've never called my friends anything before. Jerk. I've called them a dingus, but with humor. Like, yeah, you dingus. You know, that's humor. But if I go, you dingus, get away from me. You know, that's abuse. Or you jerk, go away. You know, that's unkind. You go like, dingus. You know, that's humor, that's friendship right there. That's how you grow friendship, actually. If they say, hey, can you stop calling me dingus? Get rid of it. Actually, I need that back. Do not call them it, because that's how you lose a friend. If somebody says, okay, let's say, actually, you know what? I'll tell you guys a story. There was a time when I was unkind to Isaac. So, he would always give me these nicknames, right? So I came up with the nickname Mr. Salty, right? Because he would always get so salty about little things and I didn't know why, right? And I still don't know why. He doesn't do it as much as he used to. Anyways, so one time we were in assembly, right? And he snapped. I said, yo, watch out for Mr. Salty, because he gets salty. And then he sat down, and I sat down, and he turns around, he's like, Ty, can you stop calling me that? And I was like, yeah, bro, what's wrong? He said, I don't like you calling me that. And I said, bro, all you gotta do is speak. Naturally, like, hey, man, can you please not call me that? I really don't like it. And I would have been good. Now, I'm not saying that I kept calling him that. I didn't. I stopped. I haven't called him that since. Anyways. But now he's got the nickname Speedy. I think it's a good nickname. He's fast. Come on. What you want from me? I guess the point that I'm trying to make here is that always be humble and kind. You know, always be kind to your friends. And you will get rewarded. In the end, you may not get a fancy medallion or a medal like me. Actually, medallion and medal are the same thing. I'll just call it medallion because it sounds cool. You may not get a special medallion like me or Isaac or Jack, Jacob or, you know, Carter or Austin or even Bryson. But I'm telling you right now, if you are being rude to people right now and shoving them and calling them names, if you turn your life around right now, if you start being better, if you start becoming nicer, you will be rewarded. I promise. It always comes around. You open a door for an old lady who can't reach it or the button, and then you wait there for her to come out so you can open them again. That woman might tip you with $40, you know? And I'm not saying that you should always be kind because you're going to get something out of it. No, that's not how kindness works. You may not always get something out of it. You may help the old lady and she might say thank you. Or she might hit you with her cane or something. But just always be nice. And It'll come around. It may take a few years, like me, but it will come around. You'll get rewarded. It will come around. That's how it works. Kindness? I mean, kind. Okay? It's a four-letter word. K-I-N-D. The way I like to see it is the K. You go in a straight line. If someone's coming this way, you go back that straight line. If they're in trouble, I'm not saying if they have a gun pointed to their head and they pop up in the other way and say, hey, leave it alone. They're gonna go pop, you know? So don't do that. Don't be stupid. Call the cops, okay? But let's say someone's having trouble, like their pant leg is caught on the door and it's shutting and they're like, help, 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 and you're going in a straight line and they're this way. Come back and make that K position. If someone's stuck over here, make that other K position. That makes the K for kindness. If you're going in a straight line and someone's making a circle, okay? If you're going like that, going straight, and you're meeting that circle, if it seems dangerous, go the other way. Go in the diagonal of the K. But if they're in that circle, and let's say someone's yelling at them, or let's say their dog is barking at something, let's say they're homeless, and you got some leftover pretend from that restaurant that you just stopped at, give it to them. Give it to them. You're not gonna eat it. Microwavable fries, you nuts. Ugh. No. Unless it's pizza or a hamburger, don't remake it, please. I mean, listen to your parents, though, not me. I'm not responsible for any food items that are damaged or hurt. Anyway, or any damage that comes to this video, if it ever does. Which I don't see why it would. It's a kind video, right? Anyway, help that circle out if it's in reasonable danger. If you see an N, oof, this is gonna be difficult. Hey! Alright, if you see the N, you're going straight, and someone's being rude over here, they got a gun, go diagonal. Someone else's got a gun this way, go in that direction. Okay? You can never go wrong with running or walking away. And now, finally, D. Does this look right to you guys? I think maybe like this is a D. Go in the square that you're going. Okay? If someone's got a gun over here, go straight. Gun over here, go straight. Gun over here, go diagonal away or straight or wherever you gotta go. Just don't go looking for trouble if it's not reasonable, okay? That's all I have to say. Kind. Don't be an idiot. Help people. Save their lives someday. You'll be rewarded. Hell, we're standing 81 subs strong. 5 years of being on here. We're still going. I got my diploma and a medal. And now I'll be a part of Highview's history forever. Let alone COVID's history forever. But anyways, guys, I'm going to let you guys go. Cue the awesome outro. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, please bust that one. That'd be greatly appreciated. Also, because subscribing, that would also be greatly appreciated. Also, no, it's and. Okay. If you guys liked this video, plus side one, that'd be greatly appreciated. Also, share with your friends, help the channel grow. And share with your friends to help the channel. No. Oh my god. Okay. If you guys liked this video, plus side one, that'd be greatly appreciated. And because subscribing, that would also be greatly appreciated. And share with your friends to help the channel grow. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.